Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. I welcome all engineering students in the course of Engineering Dynamics, especially the students of Khwaja Farid University of Engineering and Information Technology. Dear students, I'm talking off with you after a few days. We have discussed the rectilinear motion, curvilinear motion in space. So today, the next topic of this chapter number 2 is the relative motion, that is the translating axis. When axes are being translated, I'm not saying it is rotated, it is only translated, translate means it is only moving in a linear direction. So relative motion is a translating axis. Let's see, if we have capital X and capital Y in the coordinate system, and we put another coordinate system at P, that is small x and small y. The unit vector in the small x direction is I, the unit vector along the j direction, in the y direction is j. If I need to find the position of A, right, with reference to frame B, right, as far as I can say that this is capital X and capital Y is a global reference axis, then the distance of this one, if I say it's RA, right, of point A with reference to global axis, and the B is RB. If by head to tail rule, of course, this is the distance position of A with reference to frame B. RAB means position of A with reference to frame B. So if you use the head to tail rule, it means RA is equal to, you see, I have written here RB plus RA with reference to frame B. Similarly, if you are taking the velocity, you just take the derivatives, R dot of A is equal to R dot of B plus R dot A of B, or I can say V of A is equal to V of B plus V velocity of A with reference to frame B. R dot AB is velocity of A with reference to frame B is X dot of I, right, this small X dot of I plus Y dot of J. Similarly, if you take the second derivative, you will get R double dot A right, is equal to R double dot B plus R double dot A with reference to frame B, right? So R double dot A slash B is V dot AB. It's V dot AB, right? It's X double dot of I plus Y double dot of J, means that relative velocity or the relative acceleration of A with reference to frame B is the second derivative of in the Cartesian coordinate of X and Y. And I and J are basically the constant. I and j, the unit vectors in the x and y direction of these translated axes with a small x and y, with capital X and y if I say it's a global reference axis. So relative motion, in the relative motion, if we have to find out R dot of A is equal to R dot of B plus R dot A with reference to frame B, similarly for velocity and similarly for acceleration. So if I say the absolute velocity of or absolute acceleration of A is equal to the absolute velocity or the absolute acceleration of A is the sum of the absolute acceleration or velocity of B plus the relative velocity of A with reference to B or acceleration of A with reference to frame B. And R dot A slash B and R double dot A slash B I have already defined. These are the relative velocities and acceleration, and of course in the x, y domain. So the absolute velocity of A, if I find an A, is equal to absolute velocity of B plus the relative velocity of A with reference to frame B, similarly the acceleration. So the relative motion can be expressed in any convenient coordinate system, maybe rectangular coordinates or normal or tangential coordinates or pole. So already derived in the formulae that we have done, these are applicable here, which is for the rectilinear motion, for anti-coordinates, for r theta coordinates, right, for Cartesian coordinates. These are all applicable in the relative. Only the concept of relative, the absolute velocity of A is equal to the absolute velocity of B plus the relative velocity of A with reference to frame B, similarly the acceleration. If you are trying to find out the velocity of, for example, B with reference to frame A, then the velocity of B we can say the velocity of B is equal to velocity of A plus velocity of B with reference to frame A. Only this will be reversed. This A or A slash B will be reversed. Selection of the translating axis. Okay, how we select the translating axis? Again, this X, capital X and Y are the, I say, global axis. And this A, for example, X, Y are now taking at A. Now I'm not taking at ahead of B. Now I'm taking at head of A. So now, what we will do? Okay, RB, if you see RB, right? This RB will be equal to RA plus RB slash A. As I told you earlier, okay, if I need to find the velocity of B, then of course, if you see the head to tail rule, this RA plus RB slash A, right? And this one is the RB. So we take the derivatives, VB is equal to VA plus velocity of B with respect to A, acceleration of B is equal to acceleration of A plus acceleration of B with reference to frame A. So remember that if you see the position of B with reference to frame A is basically same in magnitude, but it's a negative of position A with reference to frame B. Similarly, velocity of B with reference to frame A is a negative of the velocity of A with reference to frame B. And the acceleration is also, acceleration of B with reference to frame A is equal to negative of acceleration of A slash B. So how you define the axis? Okay? For one of the position, of course, it is positive and the reverse will be the negative. Okay, so a translating reference frame that has no acceleration, right? No acceleration, that is called inertial frame, which have no acceleration. That is called inertial frame of reference. Inertial frame or Newton's reference frame. Inertial frame or Newton's reference frame, when applying the equation of motions, it is important that the acceleration of the particle be measured with respect to a reference frame. That is either fixed or translated with a constant velocity. The reference frame should not rotate and should not accelerate when we are applying the Newton's equation of motions or Newtonian references, right? So I'm talking of only the translation of the axis, not the rotation. For rotation, dear students, there are different phenomena and that is done in the rotation matrices. In this way, the observer will not accelerate and measurement of particles acceleration will be the same from any reference of this type. So, the study of motion of rockets and satellites, inertial reference frame may be considered to be fixed, and you're taking the, of course, the rocket, satellites, you're taking the inertial frame of reference, and inertial frame of reference is fixed with no acceleration. Motion of bodies near the surface of the Earth, inertial reference may be considered to be fixed to the Earth. So the Earth rotates at its own axis and revolves around the Sun, the acceleration created by these motion of the Earth are relatively small and can be neglected. So we say that the inertial frame of reference is fixed. In that case, fixed when you're talking of stars, satellites, right? And of course, the objects which are very much near to the Earth, we can take them that it is taking as an inertial frame of reference with no acceleration. If you see this particle is moving, there's a path of the particle. And of course, this acceleration is same with reference to frame X and Y because the frame of reference is not accelerating. Let's see the sample problem 2-14. Car A is accelerating in the direction of its motion at the rate of 1.2 meter per second square. Car B is rounding, right? This is moving at, car A is moving. In this direction, right? And the car B is rotating, is rounding a curve along this of 150 meter per second at constant speed of 54 kilometer per hour. Find the velocity and acceleration which car B appears to have to an observer in car A if car A has reached a speed of 72 kilometer per hour for the position represented. At this position, it's velocity is 72 km per hour. So since motion of B with respect to A is desired, we need to find the motion of B with reference to frame A. Okay, any observer is sitting at A and he or she is observing the car B, right? So we are talking of the motion of B with reference to A So choosing the non-rotating frame of reference axis attached to A, because we are finding the velocity or acceleration with reference to frame A. So I put the reference axis X and Y on this A. And anyway, B is of course rotating. But my axis is not rotating, it can only translate. So if you see, this is the radius of curvature, right, 150. So relative velocity of equation, VB is equal to VA plus velocity of B with reference to frame A that we have discussed. So VA, 72 over 3.6, that is we convert into meter per second, because 72 multiplied by 1000 divided by 3600, you will get 20 meter per second. Similarly, velocity of B I convert into meter per second. Triangle of velocity vector is shown. Let's see, I have seen this is the velocity of VA, right? And this is the tangential velocity component. Here, if you see this figure, this line and this line, and this is the relative velocity of B with reference to frame A, right? So we have this velocity, and if you see, this angle will be 60 degree, right? So by using the cosine law, you can find out, because you know the angle and the positive size is not known, we can find the velocity of B with reference to frame A. Law of cosine, I've used law of cosine, that is VBA square is equal to VA square plus VB square minus 2 VA VB cos of 60. And of course, and now this angle is required. This angle can be found with the help of a law of sine, because we have found out this is 18. So 18 over sine of 60, 18 over sine of 60, right? And this one is 15 over sine of theta. You can find the angle this one is, which is the VBA is making with the VA. Sample problem 2-14 is continued. Now we find the acceleration. So acceleration of AB is equal to A, acceleration of A plus acceleration of B with reference to frame A. AA is given, which is 1.2 meter per second, the acceleration of A, straight car moving. AB is normal to the curve in the n direction and has a magnitude. Of course, the normal acceleration we discussed, this is called centripetal acceleration or normal acceleration, right? We put this one, this is normal acceleration, right? So normal acceleration is inward, we know that V square over R. We know the velocity of B, and we divide with the radius of curvature, we get 1.5 meter per second square. Now let's see the same triangle. This is the acceleration of A, if I'm not wrong, this is the acceleration of A, right? And this is the acceleration of B, which is inward. And I'm making the same triangle, is inward, right? And this is the acceleration of B with reference to frame A. This angle is theta, this angle is beta. We know 1.2, this is 1.5. Now, again, use the sine law of sines or cosine or triangle acceleration of vector, you can find out. So, A, B, acceleration of B with reference to frame A, X is 1 point cos of 30, minus 1, minus 2 is 0.099 meter per second square. Basically, I convert this acceleration into X and Y, right? So this is the X component and this is the Y component. So this X component, of course, it is whatever the acceleration is the cos of 30, and this one is sine of 30, right? If you see, this is positive minus this one, and this is 1.5 sine of 30, that is the Y component. The Y component is only this component, which is sine of 30. The one component is along this, and one component of A is along this. So this one is, this direction is a tangential direction, which should be, you see, this one should be in this direction, and this one should be this direction, and we have this net acceleration, so must be minus 1.2. Minus 1.2 is the acceleration of A, which is in this direction, right? So we subtract it, and we get, again, use the sine law of sines. We can use law of sines because we have now acceleration of B with reference to frame A. By simple acceleration of B with reference to frame A divided by sine of 30 is equal to 1.5 AB over sine of beta. I can find the angle of beta, right, which is 82.5 degree. So that is the angle. Of course, this angle cannot be less than 90 degree. So I have to subtract from 180. Why? Because this angle is larger, right? And this is the acceleration X, and this is the acceleration Y. This angle should be larger, and we have to find out that should be 180 minus, because this angle is should be obtuse angle, should be greater than 90, right? Separate problem 2-13, passenger in the jet transport A flying east at a speed of 800 km per hour. Observe a second jet plane B that passes under the transport in horizontal flight. Although the nose of B is pointed in the 45-degree northeast direction, plane B appears to be the passenger in A to be moving away from the transport at the 60-degree angle as shown. Determine the true velocity of B. Right? This is X and Y, this plane, and the other plane is, of course, an angle of 45-degree. So, dear students, V/A is 800 velocity of A is 800 km per hour. We need to find the velocity of B. The moving reference XY is attached to A. So, VB is equal to VA plus velocity of B with reference to frame A. If you see this figure, this is the velocity of A, right? It's velocity of A. This is the velocity of B, which is the velocity of B, right? And if I use the head-to-tail rule, this is velocity of B with reference to frame A. So velocity of B with reference to frame A is can be calculated by to draw a triangle having scale of VA and the angle, no measure the size and multiplying with the scale, you can get the value of 586 km per hour and VB is 717. If you draw this one on a scale, we can measure it, the velocity of B with reference to frame A. And of course, the velocity of B is 717 km per hour. This is the graphical method. And of course, not very accurate, but you can do it. You have the angles and you have the values, you draw on a scale, because three angles are given and one side is given, draw the triangle and measure it. This is the first method. The other method is, of course, trigonometric method using the law of sines. In this case, you need to find, for example, the velocity of A, velocity of B. I know the velocity of A, one of the unknown. Right, so VA over sine of 75 is equal to VB over sine of 60. Using this relation, we find the value of 7.2 km per hour. Of course, this is more accurate answer because we have found out by using the trigonometric method. Similarly, we use the again sine law with one unknown, of course, and the velocity and its opposite angle, and we can find the velocity of B with reference to frame A, which is almost the same answer which we obtained here with 586. Of course, it is graphical, but it is more accurate method. Accurate method. So I just show you both the methods, because the other method can also be used, and this is a pictorial method, it is a graphical method, one can do it also. But most accurate method is a trigonometric, because here we do a calculation and your inaccuracy of drawing is not to be there. Third method is the vector algebra method. VA is 800i, right? VB, I divide this VB into two components in X and Y, Cartesian coordinates, right? So, put in equation 1 the same, VB is equal to VA plus velocity of B with reference to frame A, right? So, I put I in, I take in I direction, similarly, I take the sum in the Y direction, right? So, VB cos of 45 is 800 minus VBA cos of 60, summation of all the velocities component in the X direction. Right. Similarly, in the y direction, and I solve them simultaneously, I find the velocity of B. And then I put the value of VB here, I find the velocity of B with reference to frame A, is again 585.6 km per hour. Next problem, this is problem 2-183. A car A round a curve of 150 meter radius at a constant speed of 54 km per hour at the instant represented. Car B is moving at 81 km per hour, but is slowing down at the rate of 3 meter per second square. Determine the velocity and acceleration of car A as observed from car B. So we are observing it from B. So we put the axis of reference axis at B, and we need to find the velocity of A, velocity of and acceleration of this car, which is moving in on the curved path with reference to frame A. So I have to put the axis on the B. So this is the, of course, velocity of A, this is velocity of B, and of course, this is the velocity of A with reference to frame B. We need to find the velocity of A with reference to frame B, because my reference is B, because the observer is a B, at B. So velocity of B is converted into, is it 81 km per hour, I think so. Is 81 km per hour converted into 3.6, get to VB. VA is 15 km per second, and VB is this. Now, velocity of A with reference to frame B. So velocity of A with reference to frame B, which I have to show here, because this one is the this one is the case. So it is 15 i minus 22.5 j. Right, this is the velocity of A with reference to frame B. Just take this simple. You can you can write, this is your resultant. VA is equal to VB plus VA slash B. So from here you can take the VA slash B, VB, velocity of A with reference to frame B. The same thing here, velocity of A, which is tangential acceleration of A, which is a tangential acceleration, is just A dot. And the normal acceleration is V square by rho. So tangential acceleration is zero, right? There's no change in velocity in the tangential direction. The V dot is zero. And the normal acceleration is V square by rho. In the same way, I plotted AA, AB, velocity and acceleration of A with reference to frame B. And here, AA plus AB is equal to A, if you see this triangle by head to tail rule, AA plus AB. We get this. By adding this, we get 4.5 meter per second square acceleration of A with reference to frame B. Acceleration of this car, which is turning on the curved surface with reference to frame B. Problem 2-184. For the instance represented, car A is rounding the sector curve at a constant speed of 30 miles per hour, while car B is slowing down at the rate of 5 miles per hour per second. Slowing down means it's a deceleration. Determine the magnitude of the acceleration and car A appears to have on observer B. Again, the observer is B. I put the axis on B and find the, of course, the velocity and acceleration of A with reference to frame B. So VA is 30 miles per hour. So I convert into feet per second. Of course, 30, right? 1.6 exponent 3 is the 1.6 exponent 3 is the meters, and 1 meter is of course converted to feet, 3.28 divided by 3600 feet per second. And of course this is the radius of curvature, that is the 500 feet. AB is similarly converted 7.3 feet per second square. So the acceleration of A, this one, the acceleration of A, of course a tangential acceleration by the normal acceleration, as moving the constant velocity, V dot is zero, which have only the normal acceleration, 3.82 feet per second square. So AA is minus 3.82 i, right? This is x, this is y, and this is because this is the normal acceleration, and it is along the negative direction. Why? It is slowing down. Similarly, AB, the acceleration of B is acceleration of A is this, acceleration of B is 7.3 feet per second square. Right, feet per second square. I convert into x and y components. Right, so 7.3 cos of 30 plus 7.3 sine of 30. Right, this is angle 30. The x and y, both of them are the positive x direction. So this is the acceleration of P. So if you draw the triangle, of course, we need to find the acceleration of A with reference to frame B. So acceleration of A with reference to frame B is AB plus acceleration of A with AB plus acceleration of A with reference to frame B. I just put the values here, right? And then convert, of course, I added into I and J into J, and find the magnitude, of course, the x coordinate square plus y coordinate square, and that is 10.8 feet per second square. Let's move to problem 2-188. A car A has a forward speed of 18 km per hour and is accelerating at 3 meter per second square. Determine the velocity and acceleration of the car relative to observer B, who rides in a non-rotating chair on the Ferris wheel. Right? The angular rate of the Ferris wheel is constant. Ferris wheel is rotating, of course, at 3 revolutions per minute. This radius is, of course, 9. The car is moving on a straight line. So car A has a forward speed that is given to us, and it is accelerating with 3 meters per second square. Dear students, the question is, if we have to find the velocity and acceleration of this car, the person sitting in this ferry wheel, but its own chair is not rotating, it is fixed. So, because the ferry wheel is the reference, because I need to find out the velocity of this car with reference to this, I put the reference axis on this ferry axis, x and y. This is x, this is y, the Cartesian coordinates. So, r is 9 meter This is omega is because 3 revolutions per minute. I convert into a 2 pi because 1 revolution is 2 pi and is a revolution divided by 60. I get RPS or radian per second. VA is basically 18 kilometer per hour. I convert into meter per second. Acceleration 3 meter per second square. Velocity of A with F2P and acceleration is required. Again, VA, of course, VA is equal to VB plus velocity of A with F2P. I put the values of VA and VB that I know. Remember that. We have to find VA with reference to frame B, so VA minus VB. VA is 5i, is moving in this direction, and this is a reference axis at angle of 45, so this is x, this is y, so this means cos of 45 and sine of 45 x and y components. Right? This is cos of 45 sine of, because this is the velocity components, right? So one of the component x is in this direction, and y is in the positive upward direction. So therefore, one of the component is negative because this is x and this is y. Y downward. Tangential velocity is downward. So just simplifying with the I with I and j with j, we get the 3i plus 1.94j meters per second. And you can find the magnitude by taking the square of these x and y components and the square root of this. Now acceleration again, AB, AA, B, of course, acceleration of A with is equal to acceleration of B or acceleration of A with reference to frame B. I need to find acceleration of A with reference to frame B, the acceleration of A minus acceleration of B. So 3i now minus r omega square, right? R omega square is centimeter acceleration. In the same way, it is minus cos of 45, I minus 45 cosine of 45 j. The question is right here. It is accelerating, the car is accelerating at 3 meter per second square. Remember that, 3 meter per second square. This is the acceleration of A, the 3. Now, this one is moving at 3 revolutions per minute, so R omega square is the acceleration. This acceleration, of course, will have two components. One is, again, in the inward, that is the normal, and this one is. So, one is x opposite direction and other one, the normal acceleration, tangential acceleration is the downward of the normal. Therefore, I put the negative sign here. Simplifying, we get the acceleration of A with F2 frame B is 3.68 meter per second square. Let's see the problem 2-190. Hockey player A carries the puck on his stick and moves in the direction shown with the speed of VA 4 meter per second. In passing the puck to his stationary teammate B, by what angle should the direction of his shot trail the line of sight if he launches the puck with a speed of 7 meter per second relative to himself? He is moving, of course, with some velocity. His other colleague is stationary. At what angle launches the puck at 7 meter per second relative to the himself? Now, if you see, this is the velocity A, VB, and we give the relative velocity of this person who is passing this puck to the stationary teammate, that is velocity of B with S2 frame A, 7 meters per second. We need to find what is the velocity of the puck. But you may be a small ball in ice hockey, it's a small disc which is being passing from one point to the point, and angle of, this angle is making, you see, an angle is 45 degree. So it's very simple, velocity of puck is equal to velocity of A plus velocity of puck with reference to frame A. So using the simple sign law, because we know this, I can say we know this angle. So it is velocity of puck with reference to frame A over sine of 45, right, over velocity of A over sine of alpha. We can find the angle. This is the angle 23.83 degree, which is being shifted when you're passing it. Problem 2-191. A ferry is moving due east and encounters a southwest wind of speed VW with 10 meter per second as shown. The experienced ferry captain wishes to minimize the effect of the wind on the passenger who are on the outboard deck. At what speed VB should be processed? So this is the velocity of the boat. This is the velocity of the wind, right? At an angle of, we want, the captain wants it to move in a state and minimize the effect of the wind. And very simple, because this is the velocity of B, this is the velocity of wind, and this is the velocity of the boat with respect to wind. So it's very simple head to tail rule. The velocity of wind is equal to velocity of boat plus velocity of boat with reference to wind. So we need to find, so we're using the same sign law, okay, VW, right, VW over sine of 90, is equal to V of board, velocity of board with reference to wind speed, wind divided by sine of 50, we find the velocity of board with respect to this. And we can also find the velocity of board, and velocity of board can be found out, of course, the VB over sine of 45, because this angle is 40, right? And this one is 10 over sine of 90. 10 is the velocity of the wind, and this is 90. We get the velocity of board also 6.43 meter per second, and the velocity of board with reference to wind is 7.66 meter per second. The other problem is the problem 2-194, right? Please, the space boat B is cruising to the north at 75 miles per hour, where it encounters an eastward current of speed, which is 10 miles per hour, but it does not change its heading relative to the water. Determine the subsequent velocity of the boat relative to the wind and express your result as a magnitude and compass direction, means the angle. The current affects the motion of the boat. The southwest wind of the speed is 20 miles per hour. Power does not. This is the velocity VC, this is the current. This is the velocity of the wind. This is the velocity of the boat. This is the, you can say, current or means velocity of the flowing water. Hence, dear students, we have three things. This is the velocity of the current, right? If you see, this is here the current, right? This is, and this one, the velocity of the boat, right? And you see, this one is the velocity of the wind, which is the angle of 30 degrees, right? And this is the relative velocity of boat with reference to wind. So velocity of wind, if you see, is 20 cos of 30. This is one component and this is one component. So it's 20 cos of 30i plus 20, this is the velocity of wind. Similarly, velocity of boat is 75j. And we see the velocity of the current is 10i. Right? I just write this equation. Velocity of a boat with reference to wind is velocity of C plus velocity of B plus velocity of wind. I put the value, I get the velocity of boat with reference to wind. Now, I need to find the angle. This angle is tangent inverse, right? Inverse, that is y over x, that is the angle, 72.26 degree, east to north, or north of, yeah, or you can write 17.8 degree east of north, or north to east. This is the north, this is the east. So this angle, north to east, is 17.8, or this angle, you can say, east of north, east to north, sorry, this east to north is 72.26 degree. Problem 2-199, two ships A and B are moving with a constant speed V A and V B respectively along a straight line intersecting courses. The navigator of ship B knows the time rate of change of the separation distance R between the ships and the bearing angle theta, shows theta double dot is equal to minus 2 R dot theta dot over R, and R double dot is equal to R theta dot square. Dear student, this question is, you have to do in terms of parameters, right? So this, these are at the one intersecting points, they are moving away. B is moving velocity of B, and this is moving velocity of A, this angle of separation, right? We need what we need to find. The navigator ship knows the time rate of change of the separation distance R. Right? We need to find R dot. So if I say this is A, this is B, the velocity of B, the velocity of A, this angle is theta, and this distance between them is R. So VA, VB, R dot theta, as the AR is equal to 0, radial acceleration is 0. There's no acceleration in radial direction, of course. So R double dot minus R theta dot is equal to 0. So R double dot is R theta dot. Similarly, A theta is equal to 0. So R double dot, R theta double dot plus 2 R dot theta dot, we can find theta double dot is equal to minus 2 R dot theta dot over R. So that is the angular acceleration, and that is the acceleration in the radial R double dot, rate of change of this R with respect to time. Thank you very much, students. This completes the lecture and the topic on the relative motion. The next topic will be the constraint motion, inshallah.